Welcome student, in another video of grade 12 biology chapter 10 microbes in human welfare. In this video we will discuss about the role of microorganism is how in house, in industry, in sewage treatment plant, in biogas production, as a biocontrol agent and as a biofertilizer. But before starting, let us see the different types of bacteria or the microorganisms like bacteria with rod shape, spherical shape, viruses and the fungus. Let's start with the microbes in household products. Lactobacillus or the lactic acid bacteria, which is also called LAB, that is lab. It converts the milk to curd by producing acids that coagulate and partially digest the milk protein, that is casein. Fresh milk can be converted to curd by adding some curd containing lab. It also increases the vitamin B12 in stomach. Lab helps to check pathogens. Bacterial fermentation, that is anaerobic respiration indoor, is used to make food such as dosa, idli, etc. Puffed up appearance of the dough, it is because of the production of carbon dioxide during the anaerobic respiration of bacteria. Baker's yeast, which is used in bakery industries for the production of bread by fermentation, and the baker's yeast name is Saccharomyces cerevisiae. There are other products also. Examples are toddy, which is made by fermenting sap from palm. Microbes are also used to ferment fishes, bamboo shoots, soya beans, and to produce cheese. There are different types of cheese. Here on your screen, you can see the two varieties of cheese. One is Swiss cheese, another one is Roquefort cheese. One is due to the production of bacteria. It is due to the production of bacteria, that is Swiss cheese, and another one is due to the product fermentation of fungus, that is Penicillium roqueforti. The Swiss cheese is fermented. It's a production by the activity of bacteria, that is Propionibacterium shermani. Now let's move to the microbes in industrial production. Production of beverages, antibiotics, etc. on industrial scale require growing microbes in a very large vessel. These vessels are the fermenters. So inside these fermenters, the process of fermentation takes place. Saccharomyces cerevisiae, which is also known as brewer's yeast, is used in the production of beverages by fermenting malted cereals and fruit juices to produce ethanol. Wine and beer are produced without distillation, whereas whiskey, brandy, rum, gin, arak, etc. are produced by distillation of fermented broth. Then comes industrialization is antibiotics. Antibiotics are the chemical substances produced by some microbes and can kill or retard the growth of pathogens. The antibiotics are used in different disorders, bacterial disorder like plague, whooping cough, diphtheria, leprosy, etc. Penicillin was the first antibiotic which was discovered by Sir Alexander Fleming. He observed that staphylococci could not grow around the mold, which is the mold. That mold was Penicillium notatum that was growing in unwashed culture plates. He extracted penicillin from it, and this is how the antibiotic concept came. And then Ernest Chain and Howard Florey established its full potential as an effective antibiotic. Fleming, Chain and Florey were awarded Nobel Prize in 1945 for the discovery of antibiotics. The chemicals, enzymes and other bioactive molecules that are being produced in the industry by using microbes includes citric acid by Aspergillus niger, which is a fungus. acetic acid, acetobacter acetate, it's a bacterium. Butyric acid by Clostridium butylicum, and lactic acid by Lactobacillus, which is also a bacterium. Alcohol, which is produced by yeast Saccharomyces cerevisiae, is used to produce ethanol. Then the product other than this is enzyme like lipases, which is used in detergent formulation that help to remove oil stains from laundry. The other enzyme is pectinase and protease to clarify the bottled juice. And the last one is streptokinase, which is produced by streptococcus, and that streptokinase is used as a clot buster to remove clots from the blood vessels of patients who have myocardial infarction. So this is how bacteria are used in industrial production. Then other are cyclosporin A and stannin. Cyclosporin A is produced by Trichoderma polysporum, which is a fungus. Cyclosporin A is an immunosuppressive agent which is used during the time of organ transplant. Then is the stannin, which is produced by Monassus purpuris, which is a yeast, and it is used as a blood cholesterol lowering agent. It inhibits the enzymes responsible for synthesis of cholesterol. Now we will move ahead with the microbes in sewage treatment. Sewage, which is municipal wastewater that contains large amount of organic matter and microbes. Sewage is treated in sewage treatment plant, that is STPS. To make it less polluting, it includes two stages, the primary treatment and the secondary treatment, which include biological treatment. In the primary treatment, physical particles are removed. It removes the floating debris, and it also removes the grit, that is soil, and the small pebbles by the method of sedimentation. The settled solids from primary sludge and the supernatant from the forms the primary effluent. Then this primary effluent is passed to the secondary treatment, where a large aeration tank is constantly agitated. Here you can see on your screen, the large aeration tank is constantly agitating. This allows vigorous growth of useful aerobic microorganism in the effluent into flocks. Bacteria associated with fungal filaments to form mesh-like structure. These microbes consume the organic matter that is present in the effluent, and this reduces the BOD. What is the BOD? It is a biological oxygen demand of the effluent. Whenever any organism is present in effluent, then its oxygen demand will goes on increasing. That is biological oxygen demand. Okay, here it is written that BOD is a biochemical oxygen demand, the amount of oxygen consumed by the bacteria, that is organism, to oxidize all the organic matter in 1 liter of water. It is a measure of organic matter present in water. This BOD gives us the tentative idea that amount of organic matter that is present in the waste, and the greater the BOD, more is its polluting potential. The effluent is then passed to a settling tank, where the bacterial flocks are sedimented. This sediment is activated sludge. A small part of activated sludge is pumped back to the aeration tank to serve as an inoculum. The remaining sludge is pumped into large tanks called anaerobic sludge digester. Here some anaerobic bacteria digest the bacteria and fungi in the sludge by producing gases like methane, H2S and carbon dioxide. These gases form the biogas. The effluent is then released into nature, natural water bodies like rivers and streams. This is how the wastewater is treated using the biological method. So here is a flowchart of secondary treatment. Primary effluent will go to the aeration tank. From aeration tank, constant agitation takes place, and from there the aerobic bacteria will form a flow by consuming the organic matter. This will lead to reduction in BOD, and this will lead to formation of natural gas, right? The BOD reduction indicates that the reduction in BOD indicates that effluent is ready to move to discard in the natural water bodies. And the flock, some of the flock is further added back into the aeration tank, or else the flock will move to anaerobic sludge digester, where the anaerobic bacteria are digesting the sludge and it will lead to formation of biogas. So this is the flowchart of secondary treatment. Here's a glance of sewage treatment plant, how it looks like, what is the role and how it does it function. The Ministry of Environment and Forest has initiated Ganga Action Plan and Yamuna Action Plan to save from water pollution. Now we are moving ahead. The role of microbes in the production of biogas. Biogas is a mixture of gases, mainly methane. Production by the microbes like methanogens. Methanogens grow anaerobically on cellulosic material and produce methane along with carbon dioxide and hydrogen. Examples of such bacteria are Methanobacterium. Methanobacterium is found in anaerobic sludge and rumen of cattle for the cellulosic digestion. Why it is present in the rumen of cattle? It helps in the cellulose digestion of herbivorous animals. Biogas is used for cooking and lighting. This is the usage of biogas plant. Cattle dung, that is gobar, contains these bacteria. So dung is used to produce biogas, that is gobar gas. But make it sure the dung should be fresh. It should not be dried. If someone is using the dry dung, then it won't make the bacteria to activate. That bacteria won't be available in that dung. These are the parts of biogas plant: a concentrator tank, outlet, and another outlet to remove the slurry. A concentrate tank is to collect bio waste and slurry of dung. The floating covering is placed over the slurry, which keeps on rising as the biogas is produced. There is an outlet for the supply of biogas. The biogas is produced, it will be supplied out through this outlet, and there is another one outlet that helps to remove the spent slurry, that will be used, the sludge will be used as a fertilizer in farms. Indian Agriculture Research Institute, that is IARI, and Kari and Village Industry Commission, KVIC, develop technology for biogas production in plants. We are moving ahead with the topic, that is microbes as a biocontrol agents. Biocontrol is the use of biological methods for controlling plant diseases and pests. Examples are ladybird, that is beetle, that controls aphids, dragonfly, that controls mosquitoes. So when ladybird is introduced in the farm, it will control the production of aphids. And same way, when dragonflies are introduced in the farm, it will control the breeding of mosquito. Chemical pesticides and insecticide kills both useful and harmful organism. That's why it is better that to use biological methods to stop pest and insect. And chemical pesticides as well as insecticide, it also causes the pollution. Biocontrol method has no such problem. So it is safer to use biocontrol agents. Example of biocontrol agent is Bacillus thuringiensis, which is BT in short. To control the butterfly caterpillar, the dried spores of BT are mixed with water and sprayed on to vulnerable plants such as brassicas and fruit trees. These are eaten by the caterpillars, and in their gut, the toxic is released and the larva gets killed. Scientists have introduced this B. thuringiensis toxic gene in a plant, and one of the examples of the plant is BT cotton. So this is what the function of BT, that is Bacillus thuringiensis spores is. When these spores are sprinkled on the plant and when this larva consume that spores, due to biochemical physiological processes, these spores will start producing toxin in the gut of the larva, and ultimately larva will get killed. Another example of microbial biocontrol agent is Trichoderma, which is the fungal species. They are seen in the root or root ecosystems. They control several pathogens, plant pathogens, to attack the plant. When they live associated with the roots of the plant, that plant will get protected from several other kind of pathogens. Third example is baculovirus, which is specially genus nucleopolyhedrovirus. Attacks insects and other arthropods. These viruses, they attack the insect and the arthropods. When the plant get attacked by insects or any other kind of arthropods, and if these viruses are present in it, viral gene is present in the plant, it will prevent the infection of insect and arthropoda. It is suitable for species specific. It is narrow spectrum insecticidal applications and desirable in IPM, that is Integrated Pest Management Program, to conserve beneficial insects. Last topic, we are moving ahead with the microbes as a biofertilizers. Biofertilizers are organisms that enrich the nutrient quality of the crop, of the soil. Examples are bacteria, fungi, and cyanobacteria. Rhizobium is a symbiotic bacteria that lives in the root nodules of leguminous plant, fixes atmospheric nitrogen. Free living bacteria, example is Azospirillum and Azotobacter, they enrich nitrogen content of the soil. The difference between rhizobium and the Azotobacter is rhizobium is a symbiotic association. It lives in the root nodules, whereas Azospirillum and Azotobacter are free living bacteria. Another one as a biofertilizer is mycorrhiza. Mycorrhiza is a symbiotic association of fungi with plants. The fungus gets food from the plant and plant get protection from the different kinds of pathogen. The fungal symbiotic performs the following. It absorbs phosphorus from soil and passes it to plant. Second, it gives resistance to root-borne pathogens and tolerance to salinity and drought. And third application is, it gives overall increase in the plant growth and development. So this was about the advantage of mycorrhiza, how this biofertilizer are helping the plant to cope up with pathogens or other kind of unfavorable conditions. Next is blue-green algae. Blue-green algae, it's an autotrophic microbes. They fix atmospheric nitrogen. Examples of blue-green algae are Anabina, Nostoc, Oxalatoria. In paddy fields, these bacteria serves as a biofertilizers. It also adds organic matter to the soil and it helps in increasing the fertility. So biofertilizer, not only they help the plant to grow, but they are also helping. They are also helping to increase the fertility of soil. So through this video, we have learned how the bacteria, how the microorganisms are helpful in household work, in household products, in industrial products, for production of biogas plant, as a biofertilizer. Thanks for watching.